Spring in the line 1 has the same function as summer in stanza 1. They represent process the flux of time. In addition, spring is a time of a rebirth of life, an association with contrast with explicitly dying autumn of this stanza. Furthermore, autumn spells death for now full-grown lamb which were born in spring. They are slaughtered in autumn and our answer to the question of line 1 where a spring song is that they are past or death. The day like season is dying. The dying of the day is presented favorably, soft dying. Its dying also creates beauty. The setting sun cast a bloom of rosy hue over the dry stubble or stalks left after the harvest. Keeps except all the aspects of autumn. This includes the dying, and so he introduces sadness. The gnats mourn in a wailful choir, and the doomed lamb bleed. Why does he use lamb rather than sheep here? Would the words have a different effect on reader? It is a light or enjoyable wind that lives or dies. And treble of robin is pleasantly soft. ठीक है, treble of robin जो है वो pleasantly soft है. The swallows are gathering for their winter migration. Keats blend living and dying, pleasant and unpleasant because they are intricately one. He accepts the reality of mixed nature of the world. Themes देख लेते हैं poem के अंदर क्या क्या है. To autumn is one of the simplest Keats or there is nothing confusing or complex in Keats or to the season of autumn with its fruitful net, its flowers and songs of its swallows gathering from migration. To autumn show Keats speaker paying homage to a particular goddess. In this case, the defies season of autumn. Autumn in Keats odd is a time of warmth and plenty, but it is perched on the brink of winter desolation. As the bees only enjoy later flowers and harvest is gathered from fields, the lambs of spring are now full grown. And in the final line of the poem, the swallows gather for their winter migration. Despite the coming chill of winter, the late warm of autumn provides Keats speaker with ample beauty to celebrate the cottage and its surroundings in the first stanza, the agrarian haunts of goddess in the second, and locales of natural creatures in the third. Uske baad jo hai wo Keats wrote to autumn after enjoying a lovely autumn day. There is no visionary dreamer or attempted flight from reality in this poem. In fact, there is no narrative voice or persona at all. The poem is grounded in the real world. The vivid concrete imagery immerses the reader in the sights, feel and sounds of the autumn and its progression. With its depiction of the progression of the autumn, Keats totally accepts the natural world with its mixture of ripening fulfillment. To autumn, ठीक है ये बाकी बेटा आप सारा पढ़ लीजिएगा, इतना कोई मुश्किल काम नहीं है. Next question के ऊपर चलते हैं.